Hello, BC. Bradley here. It's still opening day, and I think the Reds might get rained out today. I'm not really sure. I haven't checked the forecast, but it's raining where I live at. I want to just show you some albums from probably my favorite band of all time. That doesn't include the Beatles, because they're in a class of their own. They're my favorite, but anyhow, The Clash, which the first Clash album I ever got was their debut album entitled The Clash. Now, when I had never heard any Clash when I bought this album. I always subscribed to Rolling Stone, and they had quite a few articles, so I bought it blindly. This is a album, is a punk classic. It was released in 1977. It's got most of them are pretty punk. They have a couple reggae songs, which are fantastic. Every song on this is excellent. Clash City Rockers, I'm So Bored with USA, Remote Control, Complete Control, White Riot, White Man in Hammersmith Palace is one of my favorite Clash songs of all time. I Fought the Law. It goes on and on. What's My Name? Hate and War. Police and Thieves was written by, Marvin and Perry. And they did a version which is excellent. So, that's what turned me on to The Clash. So their next album came out in 1978, which was entitled Give 'Em Enough Rope. Now this album, it's a little more produced than their first album. Some of the rough edges were taken off in the studio, but it's an excellent album. Safe European Home, Tommy Gun, Stay Free is one of my favorite Clash songs of all time. All the Young Punks, fantastic. And I want to just go back to this first album. Which that is Joe Strummer in the middle. Mick Jones over here. And that's the bass player, Paul Simonon. Strummer and Jones wrote all the songs, basically. I consider them, me myself, on par with kind of like Lennon and McCartney. They were just a great songwriting group. Now this next, it's an EP. Actually, this was, I'm not sure when it was released. It was released later. But it's called the Black Market Clash. And this is an EP. I think basically these songs were B-sides on the singles, so they weren't on any other albums, but it's a super... Now this harkens back a little bit to the first album. They're pretty punk. Capital Radio One, Prisoner, which I think that's what's playing in the background right now. Pressure Drop, Cheat, City of the Dead, Time is Tight, a version of the Booker T. the MG songs. Then on the other song, they get into a little more reggae, which is, this is very good. Now the Clash, they were, especially Joe Strummer, was very political. The lyrics of the songs, it was back in the late 70s in England when they were going through their upheaval, kind of entering the Margaret Thatcher era, a little more conservative and all that. So anyhow, that's a little background. The next album, 1979, which many people consider this the Clash's best album, is London Calling. London Calling. Fantastic cover art there. And the back is also so cool. It's a two album set, double album. What can I say about it? Super. Now on this album, one of the popular songs, probably one of the most popular songs on here, is not listed anywhere on this album. And I'm not sure about the actual record label. Yeah, I don't think it's even listed on the record label. But it was Train in Vain, Stand By Me. That was one of the Clash's most popular songs, especially in the United States. When this album came out, for whatever reason, they decided to add that song to this album, and I guess everything had been printed up, labels, the album jackets, and everything had been printed up already. So, on the front of this album with the shrink wrap, there was a little sticker, and it said, "This contains the hidden cut, Train in Vain," and it's not listed anywhere on this album or the record. So it was truly a hidden cut, and that was one of their most popular songs. Now, like I said before, most people consider this the Clash's best album. I don't know. I love the first album just for the energy. I really like that early stuff. The next album, Clash album, was released in 1980, the next year. This was a three record set. It is called Sandinista. It has a ton of songs. There's so many good songs on here. Now this one I consider more of a studio album. Kind of, I'm not going to compare it to Sgt. Pepper's, but they did a lot more maybe editing or adding overdubs and all that. So basically this song, when you listen to it, you know, it does not sound anything like their first album. They evolved. There's a lot of reggae on here. And I know a lot of people consider this Sandinista overblown because it's three albums. They say, well, you could cut that down to two albums and make it fantastic. Just like the White Album of Beatles, I like that extra stuff in there. Otherwise, you would you probably never would hear a lot of this. There's a few songs, and actually it had a really nice lyric sheets. It folds out into three, and then it folds down. A lot of them, has the lyrics on here, and it kind of, they use cartoons to explain the story. They have the lyrics here in like Ivan meets G.I. Joe. Really cool, whoever thought that up. So that was Sandinista. And actually, this is the last Clash album I have, which they might have came out with one later under the Clash name, but for all purposes, this was the last true Clash album. The Clash Combat Rock. Now, actually, this album, as far as the United States, it had two hits they played on the radio. I think the first one that came out was Rock the Casbah. And then after that, they kind of released, Should I Stay or Should I Go? Which is a... It kind of goes back to the original punk sound. Sounds great. I love it. And all these were on Epic Records. Oops. Dropped my CDs. And then the last thing I have, it's a CD collection, which if anybody wants to get in the Clash and maybe they don't want to get each album and they're into CDs, well, pick this up. It's called Clash on Broadway. Like I said, it's got three CDs. Tons of songs off of each album. A really nice lyric booklet here. And actually the printing is large enough where I can read. That's one of my problems with CDs. So this offers a great perspective on the Clash. And it comes with a very nice booklet. It's got a lot of pages in here. And it explains pretty much each song that's contained on this CD. It's got the history, where it was recorded, and when it was recorded. It's very good. Very good. Like I was explained before, the drummer was Topper Head-On, I think that was his name, which they had another drummer in the early days and maybe later, Terry Chimes, but Topper was in the band most of the time, so they made up the Clash. So that's a very good box CD set. Just one other thing. There was a movie made, I think it was after their second album, Can't Get Enough Rope, called Rude Boy. Rude Boy. And it's kind of like a rockumentary, part fiction, which it centers around the Clash and this one true fan he becomes involved in the Clash entourage. But they have a lot of really good concert footage of the songs. I would highly recommend that. You probably have to be a Clash fan to truly enjoy the movie. It's, like I said, it's kind of a documentary, a rockumentary, part fiction. In fact, I don't know if they ever refer to the Clash as the Clash. Kind of like the Beatles in the Hard Day's Night. They never mentioned the word Beatles, I don't think. I think they had on the drums. Same way with the Clash. So anyhow, that's kind of a little history of my Clash collection. So it's kind of overcast here. I hope this video is bright enough and all that. So this is Bradley. I think I'll watch some baseball now. And so you folks take it easy. And if you care to subscribe or comment, please do. I will see you the next time. Goodbye.